to organizers for inviting me to this beautiful city and to this important workshop. I would like to tell you some words about manuscriptorium, about manuscriptorium as a virtual environment, and about standardizing and interoperability. What is manuscriptorium? Manuscriptorium is one of silos. How Van Britten say it's digital library that would like to be a virtual environment for manuscripts, that is. It contains catalog records, it contains digital images, it contains full texts. I don't say strictly editions, but full text, and in near future we hope to provide also editions of music notation concerning full texts. Manuscriptorium is provided by the Czech National Library and by historic and music collections of the Czech National Library. On the other hand, our professional profile is not library and information science. The typical professional profile of manuscript librarians in the Czech lands is to be historian as well as Hilfswissenschaftler, auxiliary disciplines. That means mainly codicology and paleography. So I am here like Daniel among lions, because I am not philologist, but his historian. And there are different views of historians, different views on text, full text, etc., etc. On the other hand, now the first goal is not only and not mainly to prepare editions, critical editions, etc., but simply to provide full text in digital environment, automatically converted into full text, simple transliterations or transcriptions, as well as critical editions, and only after that to provide something more sophisticated. That's a ground for a say full text. So we can look at the manuscriptorium page. There is an Italian localization. The first thing is, first search is very simple. Manuscriptorium is oriented not only to scholars, researchers, but also for other public, not for general public, but simply for educated people. That means not only to professionals, but to all educated educated people. According to our experience, non-professionals, educated people, are much more able to use combined search, etc., etc., than scholars. So we use firstly very easy search with one query and with possibilities for title, author, shelf mark, and full text search, and after that there is advanced search that can be combined via operators, and this is a big problem for scholars and researchers. According to our enquete, they don't understand meaning of operators, and which is logically conjunction, and or which is logically not disjunction but alternative. That means both A and B, and A or B, two all together. But there is possibility to search according to several layers. As for Manuscriptorium is an aggregated resource, it depends on data prepared by our partners, and they are very very different, very different quality. Our internal standard is adaptation of TEIP5 manuscript module for the enriched project. That is the standard for creating so-called virtual book. It is connection of descriptive metadata with structural metadata that describes structure of the manuscript, and that are connected with such a page level samples, connected with images. Such a virtual book, compound digital document, can be both centralized in the Manuscriptorium database as well as distributed. That means metadata, catalog descriptions are centralized in the Manuscriptorium database. On the other hand, images or full text are distributed in the cyberspace on servers. So Manuscriptorium is distributed resource.
Not only of Europe, we have also for
understand, but our partners half from the Czech lands, because we are Czech national program, and another half of about 50 are from abroad, from Slovakia, Poland, Belarus, Lithuania, Denmark, Sweden, Iceland, Germany, Austria, Italy, Biblioteca Nazionale Centrale, Firenze, Spain, etc. Now back to the big problem for search is that historic documents don't use normalized grammar and standardized graphics. So we implemented so-called graphemic variants. These graphemic variants are language dependent, so we implemented them only for Latin, Czech, German, English and French, because we have no other qualified persons in Prague from implementing it for example, Spanish or Castilian, etc. It's very important, and I think it can solve the problem of authorities, because to create authorities is very huge work, and the problem. Biggest problem is that all authorities are usually created at the national level. However, manuscriptorium is transnational resource, and there is problem how to deal with it. And as for interoperability, very important is implementation of OAIPMH protocol, which is communication protocol for cooperation, is another resources or is another tools. Now I think I will tell you about some other facilities which are already implemented in Manuscriptorium or which we are working on at present. The first is Manuscriptorium individual account called My Library. It's oriented to the end user, not exclusively for scholars, but it enables special tool in my library account that enables to create so-called virtual collections.